Business Central includes query objects, which enables you to retrieve records from one or more tables and then combine the data into rows and columns in a single data set. And with reports, you can use these query objects as a data source. And now we want to create a new report, which is not based on a record or on a table. More or less, it is based on a query. And we have to do some steps to set up and prepare the report so that it is working fine. First of all, we have to create a new report object. And you can see on my screen, I already have created this file. You can do that by just use the right mouse button and click on new file. And after that, use the snippet tReport to create a new report object. There's not really a lot of things done here. I only have assigned an ID and I have written down a report name, which is a query report. And of course, several properties like the usage category, the application area, the default layout, and the RDLC layout itself are already assigned. What we have to do now is we have to create the dataset first. And after that, we have to enhance the business logic of the report so that the query is running simultaneously like the report. And then we can create the layout and publish and run the report. So to get started, first of all, we need a global variable for the query. We have to scroll down inside your report object and create a new variable. There is more than one query inside of Business Central, and we want to use one of these queries. And the query name is the sales dashboard. This is a query object, and you can find it in the list of the available queries of Business Central. The question is which record table we should use for the dataset, because actually it is not supported to use the query directly inside of the report. We can use a smart workaround, which is to work with the table Integer and to use it instead of a real record table. And inside of the columns, we do not work with the number column. We are going to work with the column names of the query. So this looks like we need a data item. And this data item is the data item Integer. And we need some columns. And now we are not able to just select the columns of the data item itself, because I mentioned we don't want to work with this. We first have to add manually the name and, of course, the source expression from our sales dashboard. We have to repeat this step for all the columns we want to use. It seems like there is one issue with a missing bracket. That's right, because it should look like that. Okay, now we can add more additional columns. The next one is the amount actual, which also comes from the sales dashboard. And the amount expected. And last but not least, the salesperson. Okay, that's fine. So we have added some columns, and these columns come from the query. However, if we will go on and design the layout and publish the report now, there will be no data inside the report preview. The reason for that is actually the report is running, but we do not read the query. So it is not working simultaneously. Because of that, we have to create some triggers to insert some business logic. And first of all, we need the trigger on pre-data item to open the query itself. And this is very easy. Just type in sales dashboard. Open. After that, we have to take care about that every time if we get a new record of the integer table, we also get a new record or a new line from the query. So we also need the trigger on after get record. And we can work with a statement, which is if not sales dashboard read, it means there is no more line. Then current report break. So current report breaks helps us to immediately stop the report after we have received the last line of the sales dashboard query object. So this is it for the business logic and for the data set. So now we have to create the layout. First of all, we need to create a package to get the RDLC file. And after that, we open the file externally to design the layout. Just insert a new table by using the right mouse button. And we are working with a classic table, with a normal table. We can just select the different fields we have added into our data set. But we need one more additional column. And here we are. So there are no differences in how to design the layout or how it looks like and what you want to set up and format on specific values and options inside the report builder. This is working like it is working in a normal way, and maybe you're already familiar with all these options. So the really difference between a normal report and a report which is based on a query is that instead of working with a real table as a data item, we are working with an integer record, and we have first of all inserted a global variable, and we try that the report and the query runs simultaneously. Okay, let's check it out. Publish the report and switch to your Business Central. Type in the name of your report and click on the preview button to get the first preview. So it seems to work, and of course it works. It means we could do a lot of more things here, because we could add some grouping and we can change the columns, and of course we could change something more here. We could change the layout and the colors and the width of columns or the formatting of decimal values. However, this is how it looks like now, and you are able to change more things if you want to do that. I don't want to do that. I want to switch back to my Visual Studio Code, and I want to give you a short summary of what we have done in the last few minutes. First of all, we have created a new report file, and in comparison to other reports, this report is based on data which comes from a query. And to do that, to achieve this goal, you only have to enter a new data item which is based on the table integer. You only have to create a global variable, add the fields of your global variable to the data set, and take care about that the query, the read of the query, is running simultaneously like the report itself. That's all. Create your layout, publish and run it, and you can create every report based on every query whenever you want.